wat jy sê dankie. Elke keer is een open plek om te sê, ek glo, ek is genees. As jy gee dank aan God, en dit is net een herinnering, dat baie keer dan raak ons, die Here raak ons aan en hy genees ons, en dan vergeet ons van die Here. En dit gebeur baie. Ek het dit al baie keer in my lewe, het ek het al beleef, ek het mense gesien wat wonderbaarlik genees is, van baie goed, en I just never came back to say thank you. Daar was, ek sê altyd, as jy die Bybel lees, sal jy sien, daar was 10 melaatse ouens gewees. Die Here het hulle al 10 genees, net een het teruggekom, sê dankie te sê. 1 uit 10 is 10%. So as 10% van die wereldse mense net vir die Here dankie sê, hoe min is dit? Door die hele bevolking van die wereld. Amen? So is het belangrijk dat ons daar goed sal verstaan. Kom ons begin waar ons begin het so paar weke terug. En ons praat van starting from scratch. Now I'm going to go through all those things again. Ons het gepraat oor 'n klomp goede. Ons het gepraat oor, in die begin was die eerste ene was, kan julle onthou wat dit was? Die eerste ene was geloof gewees en verlede week het ek gepraat oor hoop. Can you guys remember that? I'm not going to go back to that this morning. I can't go back to that. Ons sal... Ek gaan verstrengel raak daaraan. Maar wat ek wil wel doen, is ek wil vir julle gee, een of twee verse wat ons gedoen het, en die eerste vers wat ek vir julle wil gee, is iets waarop hierdie hele lering wat ons gedoen het die afgelopen tyd, gebaseer is. En ek wil graag dit weer met u deel vanoggend. Dit is die vierde slide, ek kreeg al. En dit is Openbaring 2 vers 4 tot 5. And I want you to understand this, because I can't say this enough. En ek glo dit is besig om vandag se lewe te gebeur. But I have this complaint against you. This is God speaking through John. And he's talking about the church. This is the church of Ephesus. Kerk van Ephesus. Hy sê hierdie ding, het ek teen jou. You don't love me or each other as you did at first. Look how far you have fallen, sê hy. Turn back to me and do the works you did at first. If you don't repent, I will come and remove the lampstand from its place among the churches. Dan jy sê, okay, dis fyn. Ek meen, vat maar die lig en gaan weg. The lampstand. The lampstand is this. Is that the lampstand is your thread of salvation from the place where you're sitting this morning, drawn through to Jesus Christ, where he is. And where he is the light in this church. En as ons bereid is om te sê, Here, dis reg, u kan maar u lig kom vat, dan is ons baie onverantwoordelik in die koninkryk van God. I say that as it is, because I believe it, I can see it happening daily in the churches all over the place. And when I look at people, and I kyk hoe afvallig is ons as mens teenoor God, ek raak bang. Hierdie goed wat Rudy van gepraat het vanoggend, is a reality. It's a reality. That stuff there is a reality. Ek wil dit afgehaal het vanoggend. Ek het dit hier lekker tools gehad om dit af te haal. Because my God help me, that everything in Disney World is well oiled. Vir die wereld, ja. Not for God. Amen. Die probleem in vandagse lewe is, I believe that we got to go back, start from scratch, and to find the heart of God. The world has become too technical. The world has become too automatic. En ons dink ons verhouding met die Here is ook automatisch. Ongelukkig werk dit nie so. If you have a relationship with Christ, there's certain things that you have to put onto manual mode. There is nothing automatic about your relationship with Christ. Niks is automatisch nie. You got to put it into manual mode. You got to seek Christ continually. Somebody say amen. Dis wat ons moet doen. And so we saw through that we had to energize our faith. Ons moet opgewonder word. And then the next thing I did last week was fortifying your hope. In other words, protecting us against the attacks of the devil is fortify. Is dat ons beskerm word teen die aanvalle teen die vyand. Hy sê, ja, die duivel is besig om uit aanval. Sê, dis reg, maar jy's 'n kind van die Here. Hoekom rus jy jouself nie so toe dat jy jou nie kan aanval nie? Want as die aanvalle kom, dan raak jy swakker en swakker en swakker en jy kan nie meer opstaan nie. Maar as jy jouself kan versterk daarteen, raak jy sterker en sterker en sterker. And you get to the point because the Bible says that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Why do we fall? We get sucked into this world. There's a big thing on social media at the moment. It's going all around the place. En ons loop rond. Ek gaan nou terugkom wat ek nou wil sê, maar ek wil julle hier vers gee. Jou verhouding met die Here, hoe belangrijk is dit vir jou? On a scale from 1 to 10, how important is your relationship with Christ? En as jy vir my sê, Pieter, ek is 10, sê ek vir jou is reg. Halleluja. But then I'm going to give this verse to you, because the verse of the Bible says this. In Romans 8:35, he says this, can anything separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean we no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or persecuted or hungry or destitute, in danger or threatened with death? You see, we get separated from Christ through those things. Ek kan net 'n bietjie slegte nuus nou kry, dan is ek verwyder van my verhouding van die Here. Ek praat van myself, ek weet nie waar julle ouens is. And so when the separation comes in, wanneer jy begin die Here bevraagteken van, waar is God? Why isn't he there? Ek het my lewe vir u gegee, Here. Ek kry nie waar. That means when you keep on looking for God and you can't find God, how much work did you put into the relationship when the relationship started? When you found your love of your life, wanneer julle mekaar in die oë gekyk het, kon julle nie vir mekaar genoeg gesê het, hoe lief is ons vir mekaar nie. Doen ons dit nog met die Here vandag nog? Do we still look God in the eye and say, I love you? Is God number one? You know, on a scale from 1 to 10, where's your love for the relationship with Christ? If it's not 10, my friend, we are in trouble. Jy kan nie 5 nie, because that's 50% of a relationship. 50% of a relationship doesn't work. 25% of a relationship doesn't work. And neither does 75%, and neither does 99.9% work. We got to turn back to God. As a nation, as children, we got to turn back to God. En ek weet, julle kan sê, maar moenie met my so praat, ek is nie jou kind nie, jy is nie my kind nie. Jy wil my ook nie vir jou hê as jou pa nie. But here's the deal. Social media. Wat maak julle kwaad die afgelope tyd wat julle lees op Facebook? Ek gou nie hoor. Wat weer? Hulle brand die kerke af. Kom ons praat oor ons eie land gou. Wat raak jy kwaad in ons eie land? Op borsie nog? Ah, sê, korrupsie. I want to use the word corruption this morning. Because corruption, you can only corrupt when you steal. Is ek reg as ek so sê? How much time do we steal from God, guys? How much do we take from God which is not ours? How much corruption are we doing towards the kingdom of God? Kom en help my gou vanoggend. We in trouble. If I'm praising, worshiping, as ek hier staan en ek dink aan goed aan die buitenkant, I'm got a corrupted mind. Nee, is ek te oor die boord vanoggend? I'm not. If I'm sitting in church, if I'm in the holiness of God's company, if I'm praying at my house en ek dink van waar, I'm corrupted. I'm stealing. Hoe gaan ek dit reg maak? Wanneer goed vir jou meer belangrik is as die goed van die Here, then it becomes a corrupted lifestyle. The thing is, I will work this thing out still. God just only revealed it to me this morning. Af daar goed is nie hierbo in my brief goed nie. I believe the kingdom of God, that there are many corrupted Christians, many corrupted leaders in the kingdom of God. En jy vir my sê, jy's braaf vanoggend. Dis okay. Ek het dit gesê, ek sal die moeilikheid vat, jylle hoef nie, jylle gaan niks kry nie. I'll take it. But I'm tired of people singing Kumbaya and they live in a AC/DC life. En dan sê hulle vir my, maar ek is ook 'n Christen. I had a wild experience yesterday and I couldn't work it out. And I said to my wife now, onthou dat ek by die huis kom, sê vir my, ek moet jou sê wat gister gebeur het. Wat ek al gesê het, wat gebeur het, en wat eindelijk gebeur het, het nie gebeur nie. Ek het dit nie droog gemaakt, so ek is nog nie die moeilikheid. But I couldn't work it out. And God changed the direction for me yesterday. Toe ek nou daar voor sit, op een kolk het gekniel, toe ons gehoorsop het. God said to me, that's why you did what you did. It's wild. It's wild. You see, Peter, you spoke about fortifying your hope. You came to a place last week where you spoke about the stuff and you said you wanted to be protected against attacks. And all I did yesterday, I protected you against an attack. Wow. Dankie, Here. Dankie, Here. Ek sal die getuienis eendag vir julle gee. As 'n klomp goed hierdie week met my gebeur. I'm still reeling, I'm still rocking. I'm still not so lekker. Probeer goed nog een achter mekaar sit. Maar ek wil vir die dag vir u die versekering gee, dat God leef. And God will move on without you and without me. Ek het ervaar. Klaar. It's either we do what we say we do, en moet nie aan mekaar achter goed aan hart loop nie. Sometimes Christians, they operate, ja, yeah, and then they back on the TV, and they operate there, and then they operate, ja, yeah, and then is hierdie boek, en pastoor, het jy hierdie boek gelees? Nee, ek het hom nie gelees nie. Maar jy moet hom lees, nee, ek moet hom nie lees nie. God tells me to read the book, I'll read the book. Amen. Dis hoe dit werk. Don't get shaken all over the show. The danger thereof, is that the devil also knows the word of God. En hy sal vir jou en my stuur op a wild goose chase. It will make you mal. En dan gaan jy dink die Here voed jou nie, but you've been stolen from. Amen. Want dit is sy werk, is om te steel. En vanoggend wil ek praat oor liefde. Maar ek wil praat oor 'n ding van activeer jou liefde. Activating your love. And it's important that if God says to us to love one another the way He loves us, I can only love you the way He loves me. If I activate God in my life, then I will love you the way He loves me. If I do not activate God in my life as the number one God and the only one I bow before, then my life, my love for other people will never be activated. Hallo. Nou, is 'n goeie tyd om te vra. Hoe lief is jy vir almal om jou? Hoe lief is jy vir die mense wat jou te na gekom het in die lewe? Hoe lief is jy vir mense wat van jou skinder? Hoe lief is jy van hulle wat gesteel het al van jou? Hoe lief is jy vir die korrupsie wat in die plek aangaan op die oomblik? Let's talk about love. for a moment. Let's talk about the activated love that you have. The activated love is when you walk past the chick and you see the chick of your dreams, knock your knee. Your love has just been activated through your knees, Donna, but not in your heart. But you see iets anders. There's an ander activering wat plaasvind, maar nie 'n geestelike of 'n harts activering wat plaasvind nie. Does that make sense? So I want to ask you this morning, on a scale from 1 to 10, weer, hoe geactiveer is jou en my liefde vir God vanoggend? How much of the love that God gave you when He received you is activated back to His kingdom, back into His throne room, and back into His presence? Onthou net by jy en ek weet nou nie van jou nie, ek was op 'n plek waar ek regtig waar, ek, as ek iets oorgekom het, I had a one-way ticket and it wasn't to a lekker place. Hulle haal nie eers jou bagasie van uit die kattebak uit daar nie. And the situation is this. And that happens if my love for God is not activated. When I'm speaking about God and ek is, ja, ek gaan ook kerk toe en ja, ek weet jy wat so nou en dan gaan ek nou bid hier toe. Ja. Weet jy ek hoef mos nie aan mekaar kerk toe te gaan nie man. Ek weet ek my sake speak, my God knows my man. Hy ken my hart man. So ek kan hierdie goed ook maar doen tussenin wat ek weet. Weet jy wat is natuurlik die Here laat ons toe 'n bietjie stout te wees. Jy sê Johnny, jy is living in a dream world. My wêreld bestaan nie. The activated love that God wants for you is the same love that He activated when He gave His Son to die for you and me. Wanneer hy na die wêreld gekyk het en gesê het, ek is nou moeg en ek is nou klaar, and I will send my Son to die for the world so that the whole world can come into the redemption and the whole world could be free if they believe in my Son and if they believe that He died for them and if they believe that His blood has washed them clean and if they believe that they turned from their old and followed me and if they believe that there's an activation that took place through the Holy Spirit, and if they believe that I can receive them, then only is your love activated for Christ. Amen. Maak dit sin? That's activated love. And what comes from that? Very simply this. Paul said it in 1 Corinthians 13, where he says this to 4 to 8, ons haal hierdie goed so maklik uit. It just goes the one after the other. And he says this, he says, love is patient and love is kind. Love is not jealous, boastful or proud or rude. Does not demand its own way. It's not irritable and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith and is always hopeful and endures through every single circumstance. Is dit die liefde wat ons het vir mekaar? Is dit die liefde wat ek en jy vir God het? Because that's the love that He has for us. But you see, if my love is not activated towards Christ, I'm never going to feel the love of God in my life because if the activation hasn't taken place, daar kan nie 'n connection wees nie. What is a simple definition of what I've just said? What we're looking at there, and al wat goed wat Paulus gesê het, is we're looking at two words, which is called active goodwill. There's an active goodwill, which we give to one another. What is good? It's my will has been good. That's goodwill. In other words, my will is good and I'm receiving, I've got this love thing and because I have this activated goodwill, because I've come to a place and I've activated the goodwill part of myself inside of me through Christ who has given it to me, says to me, your will be good, Peter. In other words, dan stry ek nie met God nie. Dan kom ek oor hierdie punt en dan doen ek hierdie goed. En waar mense vir jou sê, maar jy, hoekom sukkel jy so? Ek sal lank al gesê het, gaan in julle en my in. Because I'll tell you why. Because love is patient and love is kind. And love is not jealous and love is not boastful or proud. That's why. That's why. Ek is al by my agter my rug en ek praat vir myself vanoggend want ek wil nie van ander mense praat dan kom ek in die moeilikheid nie. Ek is al agter my rug as ek stikkend beskinder en hy goed kom. You know what happens if you're a child of God? It comes back. God just gives it to you one day. Unbeknown, you just receive it back. So I know a lot of things about a lot of things that people have said to me about. And then I could start off with, hello, pastor, how are you? You're doing amazing work. And I think, you liar. But I don't do anything. I don't react. Because the active love within me says, you've overcome that, my brother. You've overcome that. But here's the deal, guys and ladies. Dit gaan nie daar oor nie. Dit gaan nie daar oor nie. Hoekom raak ons met mekaar as mense geïrriteerd? When love is not irritable. Why do we become irritated with God when love is not irritable? Why do we come to a place where we demand our own way when love doesn't work like that? Dis my manier en so sal dit werk. And love doesn't work like that. Why? It's not work. It does not rejoice about injustice. Corruption in the country. We're just as corrupt when it comes to our relationship with Christ. But also, how many things have we stolen from God already? We don't even know. How much time have we stolen? How many times has God told you to speak to people, go and pray for people? You're not going to pray for people. That's stealing instructions. Love. Love. Never gives up and never loses faith. Always in hopes. How much record do we keep of the people that wronged us? Hoeveel record hou ons daarvan? Ek sal jou nooit vergewe nie. Maar ek is 'n kind van die Here. Says, you know, Peter, you don't keep record, dude. You don't keep record. And what I've learned in die afgelope tyd in my lewe, ek raak net stil. Ek reageer nie wanneer mense mee praat nie. And that helps me. So I don't get caught up in the arguments. If you want to use that, you're welcome. What is the importance of love? The first thing, I want to say this to you this morning. I want you to understand me. The first thing that if you and I express love, as ons dit kan uitdruk, as ons liefde kan uitdruk, as ons dit kan wys, as ons dit regtig waar kan wys, then what this is, yeah, I want you to understand that when you start expressing your love, then that is when you have assurance of your salvation. Want jou redding is liefde. As God jou vrygemaak het, if Jesus Christ has washed you by His blood, you've been saved, you've received salvation, and if you can do these things, and you can take all these things that Paul writes about, and what we have discussed these last 3 weeks, and you put them into practice, and you bring love into this thing, then there's an assurance of your salvation. Daar's 'n versekering wat jy gered is. Doen ons dit. Versekering dat ons gered is. Ons wys dit vir die lewe, ons wys dit vir die wêreld. Ons sê, Here, hier is die goed, Here. Expressing love assures us that God will answer us in prayer. Did you know that if we as ons liefdeloos is en ons kan nie in liefde optree nie, that God doesn't answer our prayer. We are when you and I fell on our knees, when you and I said Jesus, Jesus, Here, verander my lewe. Want toe ons opgestaan het, het ons opgestaan soos 'n beeld van 'n disipel van Christus. Come on, somebody help me. We became His representative. We became His representative. Hoe weet ek as ek is sy teenwoordiger? Omdat hy ons uitgestuur het. Omdat hy gesê het, gaan doen. Ek gee vir julle mag om goed te gaan doen. Ek gee vir julle magtiging om goed te gaan doen. That means He sent us out to represent Him, His kingdom. He gave us calling cards which said you're a disciple. A calling card which said, can I pray for you? A calling card that said to you, die lewe is teen jou, maar ek is lief vir jou, my broer. A calling card that said to you, moenie, kom ons sit, kom ons kom by mekaar, kom ons maak jy goed by mekaar. Kan ek jou help? Kan ek hierdie ding deurdra saam met jou? That's what it is. My friend, if you and I want to be a Christian, if we want to call ourselves Christians, if we want to be involved in the kingdom of God, these are the things that we need to do. These are the things that we need to walk in. Is nie meer grappe nie. God wants disciples, not disciples. Disciples. He wants us to represent His kingdom. Let us do that. Let us express our love in such a way that is in our hearts, so that He can answer our prayer. Sê Pieter, ek bid en ek bid en ek bid, man. Ek kan nie antwoord nie. Hoeveel liefde van God druk jy uit? Hoeveel uitdrukkingheid in jou leven is liefde van God? Wanneer mense met jou praat, do they know that you're a child of God? When they check you in the club, do they know you're a child of God? When they check you at the jail, do they know you're a child of God? Do they? Because if they can't, that means that you're not expressing your love for Christ. And the first thing as a disciple of Jesus must do is express his love for Christ. Jy sê verteenwoordiger. As ek vir Coca-Cola werk en ek is die verteenwoordiger van Coke, surely promoveer ek nie Pepsi-Cola nie. You see, our attitude en ons gedrag bepaal vir wie ons teenwoordig. Verteenwoordig. Die manier waarop ons praat, die agressiviteit wat oorkom soms, die, ons is allemaal daar, ons kom in die ding in. Maar die Heere geef ons een versekering vandag en hy sê, I want you to have love, man. I want you ous to start from scratch and to find out what love is. Moet nie aanneem jy het liefde nie, my broer, my sister. Moet nie. Gaan soek dit, gaan defineer dit, gaan analyseer dit, gaan vind uit waar jy staan op een skaal van 1 tot 10 in Godse koninkryk. En vraag, Here, is werkelijk waar my liefde geactiveer? 1 John 4, verse 7 to 8 says this, and this is for all of us sitting in this place this morning. He says, dear friends, let us continue to love one another. Somebody say one another. Let us continue to love one another, for love comes from who? From God. Anyone who loves is a child of God, and he knows God. But anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Jy sê, jy kan nie vir mense sê, ek haat die ou, en dan sê ek is 'n Christen nie. Jy kan dit nie sê nie. You're not allowed to say that. Maak nie saak hoe jy billik kan voel nie. God doesn't hate us. God redeems us. God hates sin, but he doesn't hate you. He hates the sin in you, but he doesn't hate you. Amen. Somebody say amen. Dis hoe dit werk. That's how it works. We got to get around that. We got to work through that. How are we going to activate this? You're going to look at the Thessalonians. They work through that. I'm not going to just give you the scripture. You're going to look it up in your own time. Because you see, God taught the Thessalonians how to love. And God wants to teach you and me today how to love. 1 Thessalonians 4 verse 9. I'm going to read that. Just write it down. Gaan lees dit in jou eie tyd en jou stilte tyd vandaan. Jesus taught us how to love. How did he teach us how to love? Hoe die Here Jesus ons geleer om lief te hê? Any idea? Fear? How did he teach us though? How did God, Jesus did something, he taught to teach us how much he loved us. He sacrificed his life for us. Through a sacrifice. A sacrifice. Hy het homself gegee. In geheel. A offer. Hy het gesê, hier sê ek. Ek gaan julle wys hoe lief ek julle het. Want so lief het my Vader, God, vir julle lief gehad het. Dat hy was bereid gewees om my, sy Seun, Jesus Christus, te gee, sodat julle kan leef. Amen. That's what he said. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. Whoever believes in him shall not perish, but ever everlasting life. Lekker. Hansie en Griekie, of Jack and Jill went up the hill, fetch a pail of water, Jack fell down, broke his crown, Jill came tumbling after. Lekker. Daar gaan hy. Nee. For God so loved, hey, Jesus, what did it happen? He says, Peter, this is me, Jesus, speaking to you personally today, Pete. You know what? God, my father, loved you, Peter Dieckmann, so much that he was prepared to say, my son, Jesus, you will die for Peter. You will set Peter free. You will give him another life, and through the redemption that he receives from you, Peter will be saved. Hallo. Dis hoe dit werk. Nie op 'n ander manier, dis liefde. That's love. Caring love. Watch out in love. Standing in the gap for somebody, love. That's who Jesus is. And that's what you became when you received him, because you became a new creation. You walked from the old and you came into the new. And so that you, when you came into the new, you became this creation. That you would take then this thing in your life and you would love everybody around you. You would walk with everybody around you. You would teach everybody around you. You will bring and educate everybody around you. People with little O's, people with middle children. Children have got to know Christ. They need to get to know Jesus today. Children don't know Jesus today. Wat is die probleem? Ons kan die Bybel ken so. But if we don't live it so, and if we don't love so, we're not going to do anything. God is serious this morning, man. God says, 1 John 3 verse 16, 1 John, not John 3 verse 16, 1 John 3 verse 16. We know what real love is, because Jesus gave up his life for us. This is what I net gedemonstreer het. So we also ought to give up our lives for our brothers and our sisters. Come on, talk to me, guys. Praat met my. Moet ons nie uitkyk vir mekaar nie? Moet ons nie mekaar probeer ophef nie? Moet ons nie uitkyk vir 'n ander ou wat swaar kry nie? Moet ons nie mense probeer help nie? En ophou skinder van ander mense nie? Is dit nie wat ons moet doen nie? Vandag sê ek vir jou, hoor dit uit my mond uit, dat die kerk is een van die grootste skindergate wat daar is in die wêreld vandag. En is nie net ek wat so gaan sê nie, gaan soek dit, gaan Google dit op, en dan kyk jy wat sê dit op Google. It's a fact. God wants you and me to activate our love this morning. God wants you and me to activate our real love this morning. That is why God says, I want you to start from scratch. I want you to start from scratch, man. Het ek verkeerd gepraat vanoggend? Of het ek reg gepraat vanoggend? Did you learn something this morning? Yes or no? Who learned nothing this morning? Let me just see your hand. Then I'll just presume that we all learned something this morning. Is it reg? So here's the question I'd like to ask you. Wat gaan ons doen met geaktiveerde liefde vandag? Wat gaan ek anders te doen as ek huis toe gaan as wat ek gedoen het toe ek hier toe gekom het? What is God telling you right now to do? Do you know? Can you hear the Holy Spirit speaking to you right now? Is daar goed wat jy anders te moet doen? Is there things that God wants you to change in your life? How obedient are we to Christ? Wie van u gaan deur 'n baie moeilike tyd hê? Ek vra dit elke Sondag. Baie dankie. How many times have you spoken to God in that time wat jy nou deurgaan? Gedurig, baie, min. En jy hoor nie die stem van die Here nie. But don't you hear the voice of God because you're so involved with other stuff around, en jy gee nie die Here kans om in te kom daar nie. Jou kop is so besig, jy bid en jy vraag, en terwijl jy vraag, jy klaar eindelijk die antwoord gekry, because you sorted it out yourself in your own prayer. You know that works too. En jy word daar, jy klaar gebid, jy sê die Here het gesê, ek moet daar, ek mag hy ou nooit vergewe nie. Mag jy, dan gaan my probleem opgelos word. Ek weet nie met wie jy gepraat het, but it can't be the God that we serve. Not at all. I want to ask you this morning, my friend, that God has brought you and me to a place this morning to activate your love. As jy sukkel daarmee vanoggend, dan is jy in die regte plek. And your love activated 100% towards Jesus will be activated 100% to the problematic world we live in. Ons sal goed begin anders te sien. So here's the deal. I want you to close your eyes for a while. I want you to see those that are giving you hulle wat jou joy steal. I want you to see those people. Die berge wat by jou is. En jy kan hulle nie oor hulle kom, jy kan hulle nie vergewe, jy kan niks met hulle doen nie. And while you're hearing that, this is what the Word of God says. When I say dear friends, then where it says friend, then put your own name in there. Dear friends, will you continue to love one another? For love comes from God. Now what you got to do there is you got to say, John, I'll use my name, Peter. Let me continue, Lord, to love everyone in this place this morning. I know I can. Even to those that have wronged me, I know I can. Because I don't do it, I cannot do it on my own. But your love, which is so much stronger than what I am, can do that for me. Because this is not my love, Lord. This is your love. And I need to activate your love, Lord, in my life today. And I also, Father God, as if I love properly today, I can call myself a child of yours, because that means I know you. But if I have a problem, Father God, this morning, in doing that, I'm also showing you a reflection of my unbelief and unknownness towards you. I don't want to come to this place to say, Father, I cannot love those that have wronged me. I cannot stop loving them that wronged me. I need to do that. I need to do that with an agape type of love, Lord. The same love that you have for us. The same love that your son died on the cross, Father. I need to do that this morning for myself. Because if I can get that right, I know that I will understand forgiveness in my life. And when I understand that, Father God, I will also know that you are love, because you are activating the real love in my life today, Lord. Here, tot vandag toe het ek nie geweet wat regte liefde is nie, maar Here, ek het altyd gedink, maar vir today, vandag, Here, wil ek hê jy moet die regte liefde in my activeer, my God. Ek kan nie huis toe gaan met 'n swaar hart nie, ek moet huis toe gaan vandag as 'n vry kind, my God. As 'n vry mens, Here, wil ek huis toe gaan. Here, as ek nie liefde onder my familie het nie, onder my vriendekring het nie, onder my kerkmense het nie, as ek nie liefde daar het nie, Here, wat mekaar kan hê. Here, hoe sal ons groei, Vader God? Hoe sal ons groei as ons nie eens nou mekaar kan lief het, Here? Help my volgende, Here. Help my, Here, om die liefde te verstaan. Ek het altyd net gesien as iets wat ek koop oor 'n toonbank. ek sien dit vandag as iets wat vir my 2,500 jaar terug gegee is, Here. My vrymaking en u seun Jesus Christus het die aktiveerknopie van liefde in my lewe gedruk. Here, as ek dit nagekom het, vergewe my vandag, Here. Vergewe my. Maar laat ek opstaan as 'n nuwe kind, as 'n nuwe skepsel. Want as my liefde nie geaktiveer is nie, kan my welstand, Here, ook nie geaktiveer wees nie. Vra vanoggend, Vader God, in Jesus naam, maak my vry. Maak my vry. Haal die verkeerde goed uit my lewe uit. Maar maak my vry. Aktiveer my God, u liefde. U omgee liefde. U versekerde liefde. Aktiveer dit, Here. Aktiveer dit. Aktiveer dit. Aktiveer dit. In Jesus' naam. Amen. Did you pray that prayer with me? Het u daai gebed saam met my gebid? Wie van u gedagtes was, wees my eerlik, wie van u gedagtes het gedwaal tydens daai gebed? Wat jy nie kon saam gebid het nie? As jou gedagtes gedwaal het, I want to see you afterwards, please. Ek wil verder vir jou bid. But I want to tell you today, did you believe that prayer that you just prayed? Can I just get an amen? If you believe that prayer that you just prayed, will you go and live that prayer? Al is dit hoe moeilik vir die volgende week? Sal jy hom gaan uitleef? Sal jy gaan uitleef geaktiveerde liefde, die liefde wat God vanoggend geaktiveer het, nie die wêreldse liefde nie. Nie binnelanders se liefde nie. Because daar weet ek wie mekaar daarmee lief het nie. Die Here se liefde volgende. Let us do that this week. Let us walk as upright children, loved children of God. We don't need flowers, man. We've got the cross. Amen. Verstaan, dis al wat ons nodig het. And walk in that freedom and become strong. May God bless you. May God walk with you. May God be with you. May His light shine from your face in a dark world to show people that you are love that walks around. May His kingdom come. May His will be done in every single person's life in this place this morning.